make them slightly more prominent and strong. Shadow just looks fine.
Yes.
Only thing, this light like glow looks fake. So whenever you create something like this, this is your brightest part. So make it a bit, move it into the towards white and pick this yellow color and use a bigger brush.
Yes, sir.
And soften it. Just soften it. That's it. And yes. that highlight, like if you have this highlight, it's this bright. One thing you have to keep in mind, all the nearby areas, those will get the most of the light. It will become really bright.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, this brightness will reflect here as well. We have created that thing, size bright, slightly more strong.
Okay.
And this. Inside, slightly bright. The only thing is, if this is this bright, so this color like doesn't go with this. Make it little bit this yellow, slightly either desaturate or slightly change the color. Because this is like way too saturated yellow. This is way too pale.
So
that's slight.
Okay, sir.
Otherwise, you can see this highlight shadow looks nice, fine. And one more thing. This one.
Yes.
So yeah, I just masked it. So it basically created this dark shadowy this thing. So like this, you can create this thing, which is making it more interesting. So otherwise, the shadow, I can see it looks nice. Shadow and highlight, all this thing.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, it's fine. Well, this is like. You tried, but thing is, it's like everything looks same. It should not be like that.
Okay.
Right. This is like you added this. It's fine. Like after this, you have to add a tone or a shadow thing. Maybe you duplicate this top of this one, or maybe top, and then multiply it. Or then increase the intensity. So basically enhance all the shapes. Because right now, no shapes are visible.
Yes.
What is it? And then one more layer. Maybe same color. Then use multiply. Multiply for darken things. And screen for bright enough thing. The round surface should look round. bright, another layer, creamy, make it slightly bright. Center, string, make it nicely bright. A glow is required, and then we have overlay is fine. Now I have to differentiate, like separate all those colors. The problem here is this selection. So this selection to fix it, I can paint this thing with a brush. So this is a circular shape. If it's not circular, it will look odd. A clean shape selection is very important. And then slightly depth. So multiply, this one is a multiply. I can take the same color inside area. I can make it a bit darker. Like foreground and background, we have to make sure it's separate.
Yes.
Like this frame is outside the center part, so there should be a separation. That is very important. Then this color and this color. So 20% opacity, 52%, only 20%, and make it slightly different. I can use the soft brush for this interior. Will be slightly brighter because it's getting the light first. Here. The walls are slightly lighter. And do it with the help of selection, proper selection. Then we have the shadow. Light. And then we can define all the edges very nicely. normal screen. It is it. To make it a bit bright, nice, clean. If I want, I can like make this thing also reflecting back light. So add light thickness. Okay. What is the same way I think to it? Next to it, it should be separate. Increase intensity. It looks bright and gloomy. All those things slightly. And if you want, you can change the entire background. Okay. And just use this mask everywhere. Just make sure it's not affecting mine. Make it clean and bright, and I can add some background nice something. That's a bit nice.
Yes, sir.
Glowing. Should that glowing effect should be there?
Okay, sir. I'll submit it again, sir.
Okay. It seems like Robin haven't spent any time on this. Like last, all the submissions were very nice as compared to this. Something happened. What did you say? The same thing. There it is. And for fire, there's an easy trick. Take this reddish, orangish tint, make it slightly more red. Change this to green or maybe color dodge. See this fiery effect. Because it's burning. Yes, tell me.
So, can you show it to once again, please?
Yes. Yeah. So, a new layer. Sticky color like fire. So if you fire usually starts from red from like incomplete combustion to full complete combustion to red to blue, right? So keep something a bit orangish and change the brush, click or select the brush and change the brush mode, not the layer mode, brush mode to color dodge. Then you can paint any surface, anything. Maybe I can pick some hard brush. I like that. To create some sort of really interesting shape. Layering. Fire, particles. Painted, and if you want to reverse it, erase few of the area to create nice effect. Just setting of the brush, that's color dodge, that's it. And then like if you just click and draw, it won't create any effect. You have to click, leave the brush again, one more time, 2, 3, 4, like this. Multiple times. So gradually it will create that like fiery effect.
Got it.
Yes.
There's no layer. It's like kind of fine, but slightly like we have color burn, dodge burn, dodge. Dodge makes everything bright and burn makes everything light. So dodge it. Okay, not in the layer, same layer. So it works on the same layer. If you click on this protect color, you can do that. And press Alt to burn it. But dodge burn is basically a destructive way of doing because you cannot do it on a separate layer. You could do it on the same layer. That's the only problem. remote control and focus. And just want to simply revert. If you revert it, it goes back to the actual, like when you started. It works like this. Click more contrast. It's a bit gluey.
Got it.
Yeah. So with that, nice. That's how it's actually. So focus on your still life. Wednesday you're supposed to submit the still life, and from tomorrow we'll start on our portrait. So we'll create something nice, like some like where we have a lot of complex skin type and like some maybe some older, maybe some creature maybe. So where we can like understand the skin surface detail and how to create those. So do that. And we'll study few things and we'll try some basic practice things and then we'll start our actual portrait. Where I something make you understand like how all this texture works and like basic color theme of a skin, how a skin tone works and there's like color profiles and all those things. So I'll explain those things as well. And yeah, then we start from tomorrow. Okay, guys. I'll see you tomorrow, same time.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.